Audi is continuing to show us that they're not joking around about electrifying their fleet. So many other manufacturers kind of been claiming that, but they've really been on track. You know, only half a year ago, they had nothing, literally nothing. Then they announced the e-tron. Then they announced the e-tron GT, which you guys saw me test drive. I just came back from Spain where I test drove the e-tron, the SUV. The video is already on my channel by the time you're going to see this video for sure. And now, while I was in Spain, they've announced that they're going to be unveiling the Q4 e-tron in Geneva Auto Show, and I think I'm going to be going there as well. So let's talk about this, a little bit about this car, a little bit about what it means for Audi, and a little bit what it means really for all of us. All of this is coming up next. Welcome to E4 Electric, your number one source of unbiased electric car news. And of course, if this is your first time here, go ahead and click on that subscribe button so you don't miss anything moving forward. And let me give a quick shout out to one of my newer Patreons, Michael Offner. Thank you so much for becoming a Patreon. That's the only place where you can watch these videos live. And of course, thank you to all of my Patreons for supporting my independent and unbiased channel. All right, let's talk about this thing. Let me go full screen. I think it's kind of a good looking compact SUV. Obviously, this is something that's, you know, it's already pretty much the most popular category of cars, as everyone's waiting for the Model Y, of course, but we don't even know what it's going to look like or when it's going to come out. So it looks like anybody who's unveiling these, you know, obviously Kia Niro EV and Hyundai Kona EV are all out there right now. You can technically consider I-Pace also a compact SUV. So this is definitely a good segment to be in. And just like I said, they've already unveiled, well, the e-tron is in production right now, SUV from Audi. And just like I said, there's a video on my channel for that. E-tron GT is going in production at the end of 2020. But these guys are saying that this one will also go in production. Let's see, I'm looking at my notes. Late 2020, early 2021. So let's just go with early 2021. That's probably approximately the same when Model Y is going to be going production, probably same year, if Tesla is smart, but I think they are. Now, these are just some sketches. Let me show you another sketch right here. Boom, full screen. I'm not really as crazy about it, sort of from the side. I don't know what's up with this gigantic, you know, wheels. I mean, usually that's not what makes it to the production, but I don't know. Let me know in the comment section. What do you guys think? Do you like this? And here's another shot of what's inside. By the way, how lazy is their graphics department, right? You know, they could have just put a little bit of, you know, road and the trees and people walking their dogs and houses there. Instead of they just put that, whatever that is, it's like, you know, what was happening there? It's like, did they really all wanted to go to lunch or something and then just decided, oh, just we're going to put a 1992 screensaver background in there. So not their best graphics design. I mean, if we're not getting the actual pictures of the car, and if you guys going to sketch it out, at least finish your sketch, you know? Even Salvador Dali had somebody draw backgrounds for him when he was too lazy to draw the mountains and sky in the back. You know, hire an intern or something. Anyway, and by the way, here's a closer version of what we're looking at. Now, obviously, the front screen that is kind of blah right now. That's not what, you know, what the Audi screens look like right now. I'm digging the wheel. I'm also, you know, the screen is once again kind of small, and there's a small touch screen underneath there for the temperature. I mean, I understand it's a smaller car, but still, I thought the two monitors stacked one over the other at the e-tron is like barely enough of screen space for me, who's used to the Model S. But to be honest with you, even Prius now has a relatively big vertical monitor, as I just found out, Prius Prime, right? So I don't know if this is going to be good enough, but that's what it looks like in here. And yeah, so they're going to be announcing the Geneva Auto Show. I'm hoping to be there to bring it to you guys, you know, if not live, but definitely the same day. And, you know, this is the third car that they pretty much announced in production within, you know, a year or two. And all of this has kind of happened very recently. Now, there's another car. I don't know if you noticed, because I was just at the e-tron test drive in Spain, and they kind of brought up all of their electric cars and stuff like that. And by the way, PB18 also going in production. It looks that way, even though they're kind of still denying, but it looks that way. They're going into production in a small number. So that's pretty exciting. But yeah, they kind of did the whole like a show all of the Audi cars in Spain, and I noticed this one car that I kind of really didn't know what it was, but let me tell you about what it was, because actually it's going to production this year as well. I don't know how I missed it, and I kind of tried to research it before doing this video for you guys, and I didn't find that many articles. So let me tell you what it is. Before that, of course, I want to remind you that this video and this channel is sponsored by Evernex, the aftermarket accessories for Tesla. There's a discount code in the description of this video, so you can go ahead and grab it and save yourselves a few bucks. I have quite a few of these accessories on my Tesla, which I will probably be saying goodbye to pretty soon, but we'll see. That's a whole different video. All right, so this is the car that I'm talking about. Now, this is a Q3 Sportsback. Now, from what I understand, and it wasn't really that easy to find information on this, this is whatever the e-tron guts are, right, which is like, what, 95 kilowatt power battery, the range and everything, just in the more sort of a slick body, and it looks like the price is going to be higher. I'm not gonna lie, I even though I am an e-tron reservation holder, this is a much more attractive car on the outside. And they are going in production at the end of the year. They're just not talking about it as much. Just like I said, I was really surprised. Let me know in the comment section, are you a reservation holder for this car? Have you even heard of this? I'm a little bit set back. You know, I thought it was kind of staying on top of everything. And by the way, that car, it was just recently featured, I think, in the last week or so in their safety video. And by the way, I don't know who makes their videos, but they're either like extremely genius or extremely dumb, because, you know, we all, you know, seen the Super Bowl video, which, you know, they said they got good, you know, amount of reservations from and good feedback, but I didn't like it, and I think a lot of people didn't like it. But anyway, so this video is kind of about safety, and, you know, this guy is, you know, this kid's playing soccer for like half of the video, and then essentially, and we'll probably get to it as I probably almost done talking about it, is the car sensing what's going on, and basically this is a safety feature. So if there's a pedestrian coming on the road, the car will sense it and stop, and you'll even see at some point. And this is not the first time I've seen it, where when a car stops and the driver wants the pedestrian to actually cross, it will project. The car will actually project on the ground, sort of like a little walkway with the arrow saying, here you go ahead. I don't know how it's going to like fly legally, because what if there's a car next to you that didn't stop and kind of hits the person, and you're the one who said, there you go, here's an arrow and stuff like that. So I'm not really sure how it's going to work out legally, but it's definitely pretty cool. It's essentially communication between the driver of the car and the pedestrians around it by kind of projecting stuff on the road. So I like the idea. Let me know in the comment section if you guys like the idea, but let me know what also you think the complications of that are, because I think there are quite a few. So as you can see, boom, right here, I'll bring it full screen. And so as you can see, the kid is going after his ball, but now once they stop, that thing got projected, and now they're ready to go. I don't know about this commercial. I am excited about technology. Just hopefully it will clear all of the hurdles, and hopefully does not essentially like cause any accidents on top of the ones they've prevented. Now, of course, CCS plug for this car as well. Electrify America, the growing network I now just reached 100 locations here in the United States. Kind of snuck up on me. I already made a video from Spain. Check that out about that. By the end of this summer, they'll have more than 500 locations, which is pretty cool, which means that they're really catching up to Tesla supercharger network. Still not there, but by the amount of number of cars that are going to have the CCS plug versus how many Teslas are on the road, I think it's going to be a pretty decent ratio just in another few months. So, I mean, I'm really excited about it. So let me know, is this a car that you guys would consider buying, at least at this point, over Model Y? And what do you think the price should be? I mean, to me, the price needs to be under $40,000, maybe a little bit more, because the incentives for the Audi is obviously not as not cut at all, versus Tesla losing it even more in another few months. So I mean, their MSRP can be higher, but at the end of the day, the price really needs, for my taste, to be under $40,000 for a luxury compact SUV, a fully electric, and of course the mileage needs to be over 200 miles for sure. But really, the closer to 50, the better, of course. Let me know if this is a car that's attractive to you. Let me know what you think about the design. What do you think the price should be? Other than that, see you guys next time, and remember to stay charged.